What's up, guys? Maverick here from the one and only Maverick, and we are back with another episode of MWL. Gonna get things started on Raw. I'm gonna be silent for a little bit, though, because, I got something going on in my throat. Trying to get it cleared up real quick. I don't want you guys to have to hear any of that, so go on silent for a bit.
Superstar has all the tools needed to win this one. Now let's see if he can put them together.
Colin, this one's going to be a real treat, Michael. And I know you feel the same way.
Yep, so does Kane.
And approaching the ring from Victoria, Texas, weighing in at 252 pounds, Stone Cold Steve Austin!
Have you ever heard anything like this? This is unreal!
As you would say, Michael, it's a big fight feel here on Raw for this matchup.
Thank you for joining us on this unforgettable night. I'm Michael Cole alongside my broadcast partner, Jerry the King Lawler. And King, we're getting things started with what should be an outstanding match.
Yeah, Michael, I don't know who's looking forward to it more, this capacity crowd or me. Right out of the gate, we've got a huge match. Heck, every match tonight is huge.
They're struggling for control right now.
Struggle is right, Cole. This is really back and forth.
Tell us what you think about X-Pac.
You're talking about someone who has all the talent necessary to become one of the all-time greats.
Man, oh man, did he take a wild swing with that one.
You're right. That was wild indeed. Good thing we're over here.
Here we go with X-Pac, controlling the tempo. This high-flying stick of dynamite first exploded onto the WWE scene in the early 90s as the 1-2-3 Kid. After defecting to WCW, he returned to WWE the night after WrestleMania 14 as the newest member of D-Generation X.
I remember watching that night, and when he became known as X-Pac, we saw a different side of this aerial attack and martial arts expert.
He's got his opponent, and what's he going for here?
Oh, he missed.
Oh, nobody home that time. X-Pac's in trouble. Oh, out of nowhere.
He's doing everything he can to get his bearings back here. Otherwise, this match could be over sooner than anyone could have anticipated.
Yeah, Cole, this is when you have to settle things down. Get the blood flowing back in your body and strategize what your next move or your next form of attack will be.
X-Pac is one of the most controversial figures in WWE history. He's been a major force in factions and held WWE gold. And he's one of only two men that have been members of the NWO and D-Generation X. He's going for it all.
This could be it. Oh, they're taking a risk here.
That's how you win matches. Quick hits like that help put your opponent away fast and early.
X-Pac has been a part of so many major moments in WWE history that, well, you never know when or where he'll appear. A perfect example of that is when DX made a surprise appearance at WrestleMania 31.
God, there was nothing accurate about that attempt at offense.
Oh, you're being too kind. Some people would use other words to describe what we just witnessed.
Steve Austin doing a great job of turning that around. We're looking at complete domination here. The guy's got no regard for the rules. Oh, and a terrific reversal by Steve Austin. X-Pac with a nice reversal. Nicely timed shot by X-Pac. Looking for the win. God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
Man, I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
Dang it. Should be able to kick out of this.
Quick pin attempt here. And he breaks the cover, forcing the referee to stop the count.
Well, that's just not enough to get the job done. I thought that was it.
We might be looking at a broken nose here.
That'd be interesting if they had, like, specific damage spots on, like, your face or your back or whatever, like, lower back and upper back. And
surprised by the inverted DDT.
Versus,
I guarantee you they didn't see that one coming. Misjudge that.
And, like, your knee versus your ankle and that sort of stuff. That'd be really interesting if they broke it down that far. And probably really difficult for them to do so, but
keep in mind this arena, the shoulder, and
maybe with enough time they could.
That's a kick out.
Nice.
Wow, X-Pac is tenacious. I'm not sure if there's ever been a more defiant member of the WWE roster than X-Pac. He'll fight you in the ring, in a cage, in an alley somewhere. He's as aggressive as they come.
Just when you think X-Pac can't take things any higher, he recalibrates the barometer and shocks our audience. Trust me, if you're not down with that, he's got two words for you.
He's in full on it.
Buzz killer?
Act mode now.
Sure. I don't have the stamina, no.
Oh, and a terrific reversal by Steve Austin.
Good news is he doesn't have any more reversals.
Oh, out of nowhere.
This is a wreck. Okay. He's moving like an uncaged animal.
Oh, my. He's wild in there.
Let's get his stamina up here. Get up.
He's going back to an old friend for that one.
You're right about that. You got to remember what works. X-Pac in control. Nowhere to go. Oh, the longer he stays in this, the closer he is to losing the match.
Just a dominating.
I didn't know that was a... Oh, it is a submission. Oops. All right. Well, X-Pac.
Yeah. I think we could see a lot of punishment inflicted here.
He's setting up.
Let's see if he does it this time. Probably reverse it again.
Here comes X. Nope. There's the X Factor, and nobody gets up from the X Factor.
What a finishing move. This could be it right here.
Those moves set. The shoulders are down.
One, two.
And the shoulders are up. And the match continues. I love this. Austin doesn't get tired. He gets mad.
Oh, he missed that one. God, that's gotta hurt.
Yeah, you're not doing any damage with swings like that, but keep doing it. The freeze may give him a cold. When he gets going like this, there are a few better.
We know it's all academic from here.
Look at that. He's
his plus to me. Dang it. Alright. He might lose this one. No. Dang it! Alright,
well, come out here, Michael.
That's the end of that. Listen, is motion for the title? You're already the WWE Champion, what the heck? But why? Alright, well. What is coming up? Is it actually Battleground, or is it, no, I think it was, I don't even remember. Yeah, Lesnar is the WWE Champion. He wants the Intercontinental Championship too, I guess. Well, that'll be interesting. Alright, next is Lucha Dragons versus the Usos. So, let's do that. Lucha Dragons in Philly.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. On the way to the ring, Kalisto and Cigana, the Lucha Dragons.
Oh, the referee will undoubtedly have his hands full when these two teams collide.
It doesn't get much more exciting than these teams set to square off here tonight.
They're broken up now. I think Sin Cara's on Raw and Kalisto's on SmackDown. So. I wonder if they'll actually give him some good pushes. I know Kalisto had a pretty good U.S. title run. You guys can hear that. I wonder if they left that part in. Sin Cara, all right.
Both legal men are in the ring and set to start things off here. We're ready to go.
We got tag team action happening here, and I'm fired up. It's crucial for a team to get out in front early. That way they can set the tone for the match.
Come on. Bam. Right, I'm gonna try something. And I will definitely restart this match if it doesn't work.
You know, Cole, I'd love to sit here and describe Kalisto's amazing offense.
I can hit him with a bat? What?
They really have to be seen to be believed. When you grow up with Rikishi and The Rock in your family, they won the match!
Okay. I guess there's a limit. I'm gonna rematch it. I guess there's a limit to,
Both legal men are in the ring and set to start things.
Okay. Well, nice little experiment while it lasted. So as long as he's in that corner focusing on them, I can take it back to the other guy. But he's in a bad spot for me to do it. No, he's not.
So is an incredible combination of fun, excitement, thrills, and when the situation calls for it, he's wild. There's so many ways Jimmy Uso can bring an opponent down during a match that by now, it's common knowledge, anything can happen during one of his matches.
Yeah, you know that you're a special type of superstar when the fans start chanting your name and you haven't even entered the squared circle yet. Jimmy Uso become one of the most beloved and respected superstars in WWE?
Well, let's quickly get your opinion on Jimmy Uso.
What hasn't been said already? Everybody's talking the unbelievable potential we're witnessing here. Let's just sit back and enjoy.
He's in a bad spot for me to use the bat right now.
You're right, that shook the arena.
Nah, man. He just used a reversal.
And what a reversal from Jey Uso. No matter what kind of a match he's participating in, it's widely known that Jimmy Uso can take flight at any time. Uso just needs a little room to land some offense, and before you know it, he's in midair crashing on you from, well, let's just say, high altitudes.
He's
been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
Avoids the impact there. All right, going to the top. High risk.
Oh, man, from the high rim. Here's the cover.
Two. In the ropes, and that may have been the only escape.
When Jimmy Uso steps through the ropes, the audience knows they're going to have fun. And that they're
still
see
in a bad position for me to use the bat
again. Seen at one time. Uso's fans love watching him, and his opponents hate going up against him.
Hey, please, I'm trying to help you, buddy.
And there's the count.
All right.
He's still not through.
Well, I ran some decent interference on Jay, so. Let's see, if we can win this.
I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast of WWE, coming to you from the capital, the Golden State, Sacramento. Yeah.
Now, hang on. That did not use up a freaking...
He gets the tag.
Man, that impact of that kick sounded awful, but I assure you, it hurt even worse.
And I... So...
High risk! No!
Oh, what's he? Not even close!
If you want to have an idea of Jey Uso's demeanor, just look at the Usos' entrance. They begin with a traditional Samoan war dance and then come down the aisle having fun with all the fans. Jey's excitement is contagious and gets the crowd pumped up for what they're about to see.
Yeah, you can just tell that Jey Uso, like his brother, like his father, and so...
There it is, the least two kick.
Man, that was devastating. And he brings the action back inside the ring.
Yeah, I think this is good strategy.
No, get up.
A lot of spring left in his step right now.
Great.
If his back wasn't hurt before, it certainly is now.
And it's going to be hurting for a while. Callisto shows us some clever offense here.
If we've seen one thing from Jey Uso throughout his career, it's that anything can happen when he's in the ring. The high-flying assault, devastating kicks, and his never-say-die attitude means on any night, he can defeat anyone in the WWE locker room.
He's about to try and pin me. Get that out of here.
An early pin attempt.
Come on, ref, count!
When
that
you're
was too late.
In full health. He's sending a message to the entire... That was
Dang
the
it.
Super kick!
Man, and it was right on the button!
Makes the cover.
Jey Uso has a fire that you can see burning every time he enters battle. The excitement he brings to his matches are like nothing else, and his opponents better be ready to be hit with any type of assault from any direction.
Here we go. This could be it. The most agile warrior in the ring looking to end it with a Selena del Sol.
No kidding. This could be it.
Oh, man. There's the finisher. This could be it.
Well, the trick sometimes when you get outside the ring is survival. The match becomes almost secondary when you get near all these dangerous objects.
Oh, overshot him.
Callisto spots the chance, and he takes it. Wants the back, and the shoulders are down.
He's seen enough. Here he comes.
It looks like all four competitors are going at it. This is what I like.
And the ref starts to count.
Really pushing his opponent to the limit here.
When it comes to skills in the ring, Jimmy Uso possesses the speed, diverse offense, amazing leaping ability, and the toughness that you'd expect from a descendant of such an amazing family. But Jimmy takes those skills to a whole new level when he's in the ring.
I gotta switch to Sin Cara. I really do. That's fine.
And now, Jimmy Uso could have this match in the bag.
And he might have to do this by himself. His partner doesn't have much left. Not today. Too fast.
Wow. He wants this battle decided inside the ring.
And that's why he's such a great athlete. Such an important superstar. Terrific reversal by Jimmy Uso. That elbow will leave you dazed. Let's just hope the action doesn't make its way over to us at the announce table.
He makes the tag.
Hi, Jimmy.
Got a single tag. He's been in full control of this match since the outset.
Folks, if you want to learn about Raw's most tumultuous period, be sure to check out the Monday Night War on WWE Network. And what a reversal from Jey Uso.
He makes
really?
The tag.
Having Jimmy back then? All right.
God, that was hitting the nail right on the head. If he takes many more of those, he's going to get lit up like a Christmas tree.
Are you seeing this? The Luchador is really getting himself going here. I got a funny feeling we could see Sin Cara take off.
Samoan drop.
Man, that's devastating.
Sin Cara nails it.
Oh, there it is. What a maneuver. That's how you put away an opponent. I love it.
Extra slow getting back to his base here.
Callisto shows us some clever offense here.
Wow, that's fluid motion. You're looking at agility, strength, and precision all in one.
So by Kalisto.
Man, Kalisto, what offense.
Oh, Jimmy Uso has been busted open. Whoa, what the? Look at this from Kalisto. Kalisto can create his own momentum so easily that he can amaze an opponent or audience.
Hey, he's going for it again.
Oh, that's it. That's got to be it. Kalisto now. That's a finishing move, people.
A great string of offense. You do anything you can for something to result in an advantage and ultimately victory.
Here we go. This should be it.
Will this be it? I think he's got it.
Two. How? What in the world? All right.
Keep in mind, this arena floor is very unforgiving, even with the thin layer of padding around the ring. Sin Cara gets tagged in.
Try this again.
Wow, what a move from Kalisto. That's how you make this crowd stand on its feet.
Uh-oh, there's the finisher. This might be over, and I mean all. Right.
And into the cover.
One, two, three.
How impressive were these two?
Oh, they worked so well together. They practically read each other's minds. I'm digging this team.
They've been attacked. What? Alrighty then. Ooh, a new trophy. All right. What's next? RVD versus Ryback. Alrighty then. I'm pretty sure that actually happened at some point when RVD came back to WWE for a little bit. Come on, that last little bit. I'm gonna skip this first one. Here comes Ryback.
Approaching the ring, from Las Vegas, weighing in at 291 pounds, the WCW United States Champion, Ryback!
You can feel the intensity level
That's
inside
right.
the arena
the
rising. I don't recall the
or
last
the
time
WCW
I've been this excited for a Raw match. Oh man, this is going to be great!
I should have him put that on the line. We'll see what happens with the whole Lesnar X-Pac thing.
When it comes down
and
to it,
we'll see,
I don't know if any WWE superstar really wants to step through the ropes and try and topple the human wrecking ball Ryback, aka.
And then we'll go from there as far as Ryback goes. Maybe hold like a mid-year, not exactly a draft. I don't know.
Let's just hope the action doesn't make its way over.
Maybe
the
do a
the
mid-year
table.
Trade.
That'll leave a mark on your face.
Going to the top.
And then have
you know, something that many people don't
bring
know
the United States Championship here
is that his
and have Ryback defend
his
for
his
it'll, it'll be a thing, I'm sure.
It doesn't take a genius to see Ryback spend
we'll
a lot of time dedicated to physical wellness. But Ryback also uses the gym as a form of meditation.
Yes, I can.
Bam.
These guys giving this sold-out crowd exactly what they came to see. What an incredible match. He's simply reminding him that he's here.
Oh, look at the emotion.
There we go.
Someone really should check out. I mean, a maneuver like that takes your career. It just flashes it before your very eyes.
Yeah, that wouldn't be a very long flash for you, Cole. But this guy's in trouble.
King, you brought up Ryback in his time in the gym. Ryback uses that time to reflect on what is going on in WWE, as well as outside the company. The discipline it takes to build a physique like Ryback's requires years and years of dedication and sacrifice.
Yeah, and I think Ryback's dedication and thinking in the gym gives us a little more insight into who he really is. The human wrecking ball might be more cerebral in his approach to this business than people realize and give him credit for.
And he fails to connect with anything that time.
Man, that was some miss, all right. I could feel the breeze all the way over here. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
The strikes have a little extra on them tonight. This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
From the top! Well, Ryback showed at the 2012 Survivor Series that he was more than just an unstoppable physical force. That he could be
Rolling
a Diver comes up big.
Alright, now, I know that the my first one's not going to be enough, so I guess I'll just do the corner.
Yeah, Van Diver looks absolutely focused in there tonight.
It don't take long.
Actually, I'll start with
what a
dang
counter
it.
That was.
Well, crap.
This guy's just too strong. The shoulders are down.
And a
Get that.
Ryback went into special training for that match, and it showed. His physical endurance matched his superhuman strength, and Ryback put himself on the map that night. No one thought they'd ever see Cena and CM Punk work together, and they had to in order to combat against Ryback's power. It was an awesome triple threat match.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
Yeah, pick me up. Go for it, buddy.
Oh, and look at Ryback here.
Dang it.
How about Ryback? Look at this fine work. He's in full-on attack mode now.
Dang it, I missed.
Needle clothesline. Almost took their head off. Here's the cover. Ryback's and he escapes with a kick out. What do you have to do to keep this guy down?
This is gonna suck.
Whoa, did you see what he just did? Incredible! This guy is amazing. Man, oh man, this match is just one complete highlight reel.
Look at Ryback making his move.
You're kidding me.
Watching it again.
Yeah, I think I'm screwed.
He thinks he has it. Oh, look at that. He managed to get a shoulder up. Well, like they say, Cole, timing is everything. I don't believe it. He refuses to lose. What an offensive show by Ryback. Nice move. What an assault. This type of attack takes things to a completely different level and leaves your opponent.
Sorry about that.
Agonizing to breathe.
RVD. Probably aren't allowed to use that.
That was rough. Oh, what a shot. That did some serious damage. Can't take too many of those and expect to be.
Do they have something besides Rolling Thunder? Superplex, super spider suplex, top rope, back.
The match much longer.
I don't know how to do that. Is he about to reverse?
For years, Monday night has been the most exciting night in sports entertainment, and the action we're seeing here is a lot of the reason why.
Ryback is not someone to sleep on. Good grief! How is he still conscious?
Yep, I'm screwed. I should have gone with one.
Looking for all the glory here. And he kicks out. And he lives to fight again. Just when you thought it was over. Wow.
Taking a bit of a beating so far, but nothing that can't be overcome.
Dang it. Come on. There we go.
If you're just tuning in, I want to welcome everyone to this broadcast of WWE, coming to you from the capital of the Golden State, Sacramento.
Oh my, Van Diver comes up big there. Van Diver looks absolutely focused in there tonight.
Come on, come on, come on.
I think we know the five-star frog splash. Oh man, that is a thing of beauty.
Freaking got him.
And this has got to be
1, 2, 3.
What a tremendous victory.
One of a kind. All right. That was pretty fun. That was fun. I liked that.
You have to like this display. Well, I like the display, but I don't know how much trust there is in the ring.
Well, that's the end of Raw. That was fun. That was fun. I liked that. Alright. So, So we got Lesnar and X-Pac, and apparently it's gonna be the Intercontinental title and not the WWE title. Really interesting. All right, so what we got here? Tyler Breeze and R-Truth. Tyler Breeze wins. Tyson Kidd and Maverick. Maverick wins. Woohoo! Heath Slater, Dallas, Fandango, and Daryl Sullivan. Fandango beat Daryl Sullivan. Oh, wow. So, rivalry matches. Antonio Bannon versus Curtis Axel. Victor versus Connor. And Baron Corbin versus Hideo Itami. Again? No. Former champion Hideo Itami starts a new Ruthless Championship reign. Okay. Whatever. Alright, Antonio Bannon versus Curtis Axel. Let's play it. This should be interesting, actually. Yeah, sorry, if it wasn't for the title, I wasn't gonna do it there. I'm sorry. I've played those two against each other so many times right now that I don't feel like playing as them again, unless it's for the NXT title, so. I've never seen Antonio Bannon's singles entrance, though. Not that it really matters. I'm not going to get to here either. But I will play as him. And I will pick up the scraps.
I think it's safe to say, King, that he's not at 100%
Mr. Slater.
After that brutal assault before the match started.
Yeah, oh! I think that's safe.
Work is being put in by Curtis Axel. Wow, what a slam to the ground.
He really just traversed it.
Is he still conscious? Man, that looked bad.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Crap. Man, Axel's going crazy with her reversals.
Narrowly avoids the attack there.
There's plenty to talk about when dealing with Bannon.
You're talking about someone who has all the talent necessary to become one of the all-time greats.
Suplexes? I know two of them are the same, but one of them is different. The last one was,
Wow! He's still down at
dang it!
Eats the canvas!
Really?
Curtis Axel showing some adversity right now.
Crap.
Looks like he's
okay,
I've
almost
back.
Got the, almost got my second finish, or reversal long. Back. Reversal's coming back quickly.
You have to wonder what's going through these guys' minds in a match of this magnitude.
Screw. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Got out of the way of that one.
And you got no reversals left. So,
oh, man.
Yeah.
How do you beat an opponent that can do that to you?
Bam, bam, bam. Is that the crap?
We're seeing two outstanding athletes looking to prove their dominance in there. But only one can walk
bam.
Out victorious.
Whoops! If he keeps up this pace, this could turn real ugly real fast. Oh my gosh!
Forgive.
Going for broke.
Swing time. One, two, three.
We've talked about Curtis Axel's incredible family history in this business.
Six.
So it makes complete
seven.
Sense.
Yeah, only seven.
Big, and it might be just enough to end this one.
Let's see if I can pin him with that. If I pin him with that, that's going to be awesome.
Think he's got him. Wow.
Okay, I didn't think I would. But...
determination. A knockdown drag
okay, so I definitely don't have spring.
With a big stomp.
And these guys are throwing bombs. They're pulling out all the stops.
When this guy's on, look out.
He's about to. Yes, he is. Not happening, bro.
Not today, too fast.
Look at this. Oh, no.
It's just that.
Wow.
We're going to rearrange the face here.
I can't use my last reversal. Not yet. I have to. Not unless I'm desperate.
Amount of power.
And I'm not desperate yet.
These guys are covers. Oh, look at that. He managed to get a shoulder up.
Well, like they say, Cole, timing is everything.
sees the opportunity
to
go high.
Crap.
Curtis Axel with the offense.
Whoa! A direct hit. Talk about getting tagged and knocked in the middle of next week.
So, I do have springboard.
We're looking at complete domination.
All right, what's his other inverted Frankensteiner?
In here.
Let's try it. Turn around. Crap.
Curtis Axel with the excellent move to get out. Looking to catch him off guard.
Crap.
And it's up. He got the shoulder up.
Come here. Oh, wrong one.
These guys giving this sold-out crowd exactly what they came to see. What an incredible
match.
What
the heck is that?
Watch it. Watch it. That's it. It's over. It's over. Hey, one more time just in case you missed it.
Let's drag it to the ring, or to the center. And one, two, three. Antonio Bannon with his first singles win.
You want to talk about
where Daryl Rage was?
High impact sports entertainment. Oh, that was a match for the record. And here's just some of the I can't believe what we just saw. Highlight after highlight.
Here's your winner, Charming Antonio Bannon.
And that's a huge win for this guy.
I'll tell you what, Cole, I could watch those two go at it each and every week. What a match. What a match that was, ladies and gentlemen.
All right.
Thanks for joining.
Slater's really not wasting any time, is he? Trying to go crazy on him. Alright, and what was next? I think it's the last one on NXT. Victor versus Connor. Really weird, because they won the last one. They were able to put their differences aside, and I guess they gotta have a match. I really hope this doesn't lead to a breakup of the team, because really need all the teams possible. Don't want a bare bones, you know, tag division or a women's division. That's really why I broke down WCW or, well, Nitro. Tag team champions going at it.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring. Representing the Ascension from Calgary, Alberta, Canada.
The Canadian.
19 pounds, one half of the NXT Tag Team Champions, Victor.
King, I think it's safe to say that whatever Victor lacks in WWE.
I'm trying to think of a How I Met Your Mother style joke, but I can't think of any. I'm not that clever.
Kid Cole, I can't wait to see what happens when the bell rings and these two finally get to go at each other.
What is a champion versus champion? You got a rivalry with Brock Lesnar and X-Pac, and now you got tag team champions going up against each other. That's kind of weird. You know what, if the team is split up, I may be able to make an edit. Whoever loses, If the team splits up, whoever loses, I'll make an edit to their attire and everything. Make them somewhat.
Representing the Ascension from Grand Rapids, Michigan, weighing in at 265 pounds, one half of the NXT Tag Team Champions, Connor.
I doubt they'll break up. I doubt. I'm sure they can stick around.
Sometimes a super.
All right. So Victor and Connor. I'm gonna play as Connor. Okay.
This should be an incredible matchup. I mean, both men have extensive offensive repertoires, lasting endurance, and an insatiable appetite to be number one.
And they're tag teams together, tag team champions. I'll also vacate the tag team titles if they end up splitting up. And I'll do
a minor miracle to keep one of them down.
I'll do a.
Into the chin lock.
I'm gonna hear good
Definitely looking good so far. Hasn't taken too much punishment up to this point.
He's looking to create
some
separation here.
Whoa, and a bit of a test of strength here.
I love it. This is a good old-fashioned contenders
for the vacant NXT Tag Team Championships if they split the teams. So this is all based on ifs.
Look at Victor here. The complete lack of respect Connor and his partner Victor have for those.
Sorry, give me a sec.
Number four makes me absolutely sick.
Boom.
Oh, out of nowhere.
Quick thinking by Connor there.
Powerful and resourceful. That's a dangerous combination.
All right, I don't really have anything else that's interesting to say on this one. I'm gonna go silent for a bit.
That'll go a long way as this one progresses.
Uh-oh, climbing the turnbuckle. No! Where else but in the WWE are you gonna see something like that?
Of course, that lack of respect the king is talking about has resulted in the Ascension taking some pretty hard verbal shots, the likes of the Road Warriors and Demolition.
Yeah, but remember what happened to Connor and Victor when they got in the ring with the APA, the NWO, and the New Age Outlaws on Raw. That wasn't a pretty sight.
Was a wild strike. Talking about missing the target.
Yeah, it looked like it was completely out of desperation.
He's going to take a chance here.
Yeah, I don't know if this is going to be worth it or not. Extra slow. Get him some air here.
I need some too after sitting next to you.
Connor is getting himself some now. When you have the disdain for your opponents and the skills like this powerhouse has.
That's it. He's done.
Okay, this Connor comes in at 268, but to me, I'd say he competes more like he's 368.
Oh, yeah, he's certainly powerful, Cole. That's probably why he's so confident, too.
And Victor's showing us that impressive offense. Victor's energy level right now is off the charts.
That wild strike found nothing but empty air that time.
Man, that's what you call swinging for the fences. What? Does he have his eyes open? Oh, that's devastating.
And the taunting continues.
You can see him struggling to stand after all the damage he's taken.
Oh, wow.
Kane, you're right about Connor's confidence, but he's got to be careful with that. We've seen it get him in trouble on a few occasions. He's trying to mangle his face here.
Trying to get under his opponent's skin with this one. And the turnbuckle does the damage. Few sights better than seeing all those legends attack the Ascension on Raw a while back.
There's no quitting these guys, but unfortunately only one of them can be victorious here tonight. And there's the reversal from Victor. The end may be to Victor. What a maneuver.
Hey, the shoulders are down.
Here. Here we go.
That's it. He's out. Uh-oh. Big move coming.
Oh, Connor may have it. move by Connor.
Oh, man, there's the finisher. This could be it.
Hey, Cole, this could do it.
I think so.
One, two, three. Maybe this can... Maybe after this, they can put it behind them. Maybe. We'll see.
You have to like this display.
After what these two just went through, they have a tremendous amount of respect for each other.
All right. That's a good sign. There's NXT for this episode. So, as soon as this gets done with its saving and loading and all that, that is the end of NXT for this episode. I already said that, didn't I? Yikes. Okay. So we got SmackDown, Helluva Arrow versus those two guys again. Nation of Domination again. No, I'm not going to play that one. Cameron versus Summer Rae. Summer Rae wins. Bo Dallas versus Christian. Bo Dallas wins. Golden Stardust versus the Hardy Boys. Golden Stardust wins. And The Rock versus Kevin Owens. I'm going to play that one. I'm going to play that one because that one looks awesome. So now it's Goldust versus Enzo Amore. What? No, because I just did one. I'm not going to play that. So. Tag team where they're on the same team. Orton and Sheamus, that should be interesting. Versus the Dudley Boys, who were the WCW Tag Team Champions. That's going to make things really interesting. It's probably going to skip the entrance, so they're not really even going to say WCW Tag Team Champions. Gosh, I can't wait to do 3D. I cannot wait to do 3D. 2K17 can't come soon enough. Oh, they should do table finishers, so you can do 3D on the table. That'll be awesome. As soon as it's done loading. Any second now. 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 No? Alright, well. Gonna have to give it a minute. There we go. I was concerned for a second there. World Heavyweight Champion.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring from St. Louis, Missouri. Weighing in at 245 pounds, the World Heavyweight Champion.
They kept the music in. On certain matches, I would let it play fully. Like when doing a title match, I would let it play fully through. But if they're just going to leave the music out, it's going to be really boring for you guys. It's probably boring enough as it is. I don't know. I haven't gotten any feedback on whether or not leaving the entrances in is boring. Interesting thing that happened in the game, forcing people in a rivalry against each other to do a tag team match.
Man, both of these teams are determined.
Like even WWE doesn't really do that very often anymore. Here come the Dudley Boys. Oh, did I put them in separately? Oops, I gotta fix that.
One half of the WCW World Tag Team Champions, the Hardcore Icon, Devon
the referee will undoubtedly have his...
And here comes Bubba.
And his tag team partner, from parts unknown, one half of the WCW World Tag Team Champions, the Hardcore Icon, Bubba Dudley.
Okay. So, who to play as? Who to play as? Randy Orton. Okay.
And here we go. This tag team match is going to be heated, to say the least.
I'm going to go silent for a bit. I don't really have anything interesting to say right now.
Oh, this is dangerous right here.
Oh, I can't look. Wow! Look out below! Look out!
How do you sum up Dudley's performance as of late?
Well, quick!
Right now
quick,
he has to be
quick,
thinking about working well together with his partner and getting the win in this non-title match. Oh boy, I think the referee is out of it. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
One move after the other. It's devastating.
This is hard to watch. This is going to be bad.
A piercing strike.
Dang it. It didn't work.
Reaching for the tag. Wait a second.
Sheamus?
Where's he going?
I can't believe this, King. I think he's going to leave his partner to fend for himself.
Oh, heck no.
And now that his...
He goes to the...
And he kicks out.
And he lives to fight again. Oh, man. Orton's so dangerous. I mean, just when you think you have him down, he gets right back up.
It's got to be hard to rebound from that one.
Well, Randy Orton's got awfully heavy feet, and he's not afraid to use them. One thing you can be sure of when you're squaring off with the Viper, you're going to wind up with a size 13 boot prints all over your body.
Oh, crap.
The range of emotions here is startling. There's almost an unknowing of what to expect.
I know. I mean, I got goosebumps. This match is going to be so unpredictable. I just can't wait. Oh, look out here.
You could call this a good old-fashioned butt whooping.
Yeah, that's exactly what we're witnessing. A butt whooping. Wait! Is he still conscious? Man, that looked bad.
It's true what you were saying about the Apex Predator before, King. The Randy Orton stomp is a move that has left its mark physically and mentally on more than a few unlucky opponents.
What a beast Randy Orton has been so far in this match. Oh, they're taking a risk here.
That's how you win matches. Hot crowd here tonight in Minneapolis, a city so rich in wrestling tradition.
Oh, out of nowhere!
That can't... And he breaks the cover, forcing the referee to stop the count.
Well, that's just not enough to get the job done. Randy Orton refuses to lose here tonight.
Another thing is, it's not just the force behind Randy Orton's signature stomp, is it? It's the fact that once he starts to lay it on you, he doesn't stop until he's battered your body from head to toe.
Yeah, if the Viper decides to get his stomp on, you'll feel like you got marched over by half the U.S. Army by the time he's done with you. Orton's got him.
This guy can go toe-to-toe with anybody.
He's showing a reversal.
Just making his presence felt there. He's setting, and there's the reversal. We've seen some great tag team action over the years here in WWE, and I can attest that this is no different.
Another incredible battle of Randy Orton's was when he squared off against Batista in a steel cage for the WWE Championship. The match against the former Evolution members took place at Extreme Rules, and believe me, it was brutal. Is he really going to... Look at this! Oh, it's a long way down! Oh!
He's seen enough. Here he comes!
Look how slow he is to recover here. That was some serious punishment.
Sometimes that's all it takes.
Wow! If he keeps this up, this could be over quick.
Man, what a brutal attack. I'm telling you, if you didn't suffer from internal injuries before, you are now. I can guarantee it.
We're coming to you live from Minneapolis, which of course was the home of the AWA for so many decades.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
And he's in there trying to get something going for his partner. Quick thinking to avoid that. Not today, too fast.
Stay down.
And he has to make a tag to his fresh partner.
Talk about having a reserve in the fuel tank.
Oh, the Viper's locked in. Randy's hearing the voices in his head. This is how he gets that focus, that strength. The Viper can dial up that intensity whenever he chooses.
No way. What a move from Randy Orton. That's how you impress the WWE Universe, folks. The pump kick. See you next time.
Man, that could not only end the match, that could end a career. Look out below.
Look out.
You can practically feel the wear and tear that's been dug throughout this match.
He can do it here.
I think he's got it.
Unleashing it for the second time now. Nobody home there.
Nobody home? Cole, that looked like the house has been empty for months.
Gonna have to shake off the moderate damage that's been inflicted here and find a way to maintain the upper hand. His nose might end up where his ear is by the time this one's over.
Wow, what an onslaught. Orton's just vicious.
Oh no, we know what this is.
Astonishing maneuver by Randy Orton. Look at him, Michael. I mean, those moves have really started to add up. Boy, he just got laid out.
He's setting it up.
What a counter that was. Oh, out of nowhere. Wait, nice reversal. Oh, wow.
Well, he's got his opponent, and what's he going for here?
Ferocious blow. Man, he's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously rung there.
Shoulders down. This could be it.
Count breath, count. Randy Orton, no problem getting out of that one.
Extra slow getting back to his base here.
Hey, this may very well be it. Two.
Hot crowd here. Indianapolis, a city so rich in wrestling tradition. There can only be one top dog here in the WWE, and a win here will go a long way in solidifying one of these guys' claims of being the best in the business.
Now, even if you can get back to your feet after a move like that, at this stage of the match, you're still struggling to find your balance. And he goes for the cover.
This is it.
Never think you have things well in hand when you face Randy Orton. He'll strike when you least expect it. Hey,
Randy Orton coldly, sadistically stomping away again at every body part.
Orton stop. Randy Orton has done it.
Randy Orton stomping everything in sight. This is vintage Orton.
Not this.
He's looking at it again. Randy Orton delivers the punt kick, knocks him into next week.
Man, that punt kick, that puts an end to any opponent.
What a finishing move. This could be it right here.
Looking for all the glory here.
Be worrying about long-term injuries for sure.
The toll from this match is really starting.
This should do it right there.
I think this is it.
Taking on some moderate offense here. Going to need to start playing a little better defense. He gets the tag.
You can see him struggling to stand after all the damage he's taken. Playing mind games.
Yeah, a little intimidation there. Wow, he's still down after that. Inside the ring again.
Yeah, and they should be. This is where the action needs to be. Man, he might need to get a new identification photo taken after this one's over.
You're not kidding. After this one's over, his own mother won't recognize him.
Oh, that was fast.
Shoulders down. Is it enough?
This may be it.
Man, what a maneuver.
I've seen every episode of SmackDown over the years, and I assure you this one ranks right up there with the best. Good Lord, that wasn't even close.
So that's what it's like being so far off the mark.
He's making a statement here with this attack. That's got to be it. Randy Orton, how about that finishing move? He's setting it up.
Here we go.
This is the RKO. See you next time.
Yeah, they'll never be the same after that RKO. RKO!
Makes the cover.
Here we go. One, two, three.
They did it! Jeez. They won the match!
That was tough. They were tough people. They were tough.
I can't believe what we saw during this one. Look at this. This was,
there were some unbelievable highlights.
Oh, those WWE competitors tore this arena apart.
Here we go, RKO. Beat the crap out of Bubba Ray. And go for the pin.
Here are your winners. The Apex competitor, Randy Orton.
And only Randy Orton. All right. I guess there's one more match. I completely forgot, so let's find out which match it is. Alright. The Rock. Oh yeah, The Rock and Kevin Owens. This I had to see. There was a little glimpse of Rock versus Kevin Owens in that Fatal 4-Way match I did. This one's going to be a whole lot more awesome, I think. I have a feeling. I should have made this for the U.S. title, but, you know what? No, that's what I'm going to do. If Kevin Owens beats me playing as The Rock, or if I play as Kevin Owens and beat The Rock, then I'm going to go ahead and give him a match on the next SmackDown for the U.S. title.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, the United States champion, The Rock.
You can feel the intensity level inside the arena rising.
I like that strategy a little bit, using things that happen naturally to influence it myself. It's like a combination of interference and letting stuff happen naturally. Kevin Owens is pretty good though. Like, I played as him a few times and
approaching the ring.
So who am I playing as? I'm playing as Kevin Owens. Alright, well, if I beat The Rock here, the U.S. title match on the next SmackDown, which will be probably on the next episode.
Brand of entertainment and say, this is what WWE's all about.
Beating The Rock is going to be easier said than done.
Who's going to end up with the upper hand?
Well, I think it's too difficult to tell, even from this angle.
His midsection taking a lot of damage here. And now here's Kevin Owens. In full control.
Crap.
We may have discovered his favorite move.
You think? He seems to use it often enough.
Dang, Rock.
Reversal. Kevin Owens showing his skills.
The Rock is under mad assault. Kevin Owens made an impact on day one after beating CJ Parker in his debut match in NXT TakeOver Rival. He brutally attacked unsuspecting former friend Sami Zayn just moments after winning the NXT Championship.
And they didn't talk about that ever again. Except it was like a whole point of their rivalry for about 2 years.
And we're back to this form of attack.
Yes, we are. The same form of attack we've seen before.
But dang it. I missed. I thought I was going to make that one. The Rock is not going to make this easy on me. If I even win, it's not going to be easy. Good. I like that.
Destruction no one was expecting.
I certainly didn't expect to see this kind of damage.
As John mentioned earlier, Kevin Owens refused to wait at the back of the line when he arrived in NXT. And one of the reasons he targeted Sami Zayn, he says, was to provide a better life for his family.
All right. Well, this is unfortunate.
Here comes The Rock. The Brahma Bull just unloading on him here. Let's get this thing done inside the ring.
The face is absorbing a lot of damage here.
Look at this. Thinking to avoid that.
Oh, he missed that one. God, that's gotta hurt.
Yeah, you're not doing any damage with swings like that, but keep doing it. The breeze may give him a cold.
You know, I can respect providing for your family just as much as the next guy, but there's a way to go about that. And Kevin Owens went about it the absolute wrong way. You don't attack a friend to get to the top.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Oh my God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
Legacy.
And he brings the action back inside the ring.
Yeah, I think this is good strategy.
He's looking to keep him grounded here.
Come on.
One of the things I always think of, and I've said it before, is The Rock's This Is Your Life segment. I mean, I was watching on a monitor in the locker room, and maybe I shot Rocky with his sixth grade home ec teacher, his high school football coach, and high school girlfriend. It was hilarious. It was one of the highest rated segments in the history of Monday Night Raw.
Jeez, he's a reversal king.
The Rock going to work now. I'm not sure I can watch this.
For your face, as you can see, everything hurts.
No kidding, that's hurting me. Look out!
Wow, Michael, you really brought me back with The Rock. This Is Your Life. I mean, I had one of the best seats in the house that night, right here in the broadcast booth.
Now, the thing that was so funny about that was Mankind and Rock were bitter rivals, and then became a successful tag team. A reason Mankind wanted to do that was to live out his fantasy of being Ralph Edwards, who was the original host of This Is Your Life. That's it. He's done.
Look at this. There's absolutely no wasted motion in this attack.
I don't know how much more damage he can take. Back into the ring.
I'm counting it. That's actually a very smart Kevin Owens type move. Not smart, but that's something Kevin Owens would totally do. Use a signature outside the ring and just run back in for the count out. That's definitely something Kevin Owens would do. So, on the next episode of SmackDown, he will get his U.S. title chance, but Rock's going to have championship advantage there, so we'll see how that works. Okay. Let's get rid of... Ooh, Roman Reigns and Finn Balor. Well, we already saw that in real life. Roman Reigns won on this one. X-Pac, Ryback, and Cesaro. Ryback beat Cesaro. Then you had New Day versus Primetime Players. Primetime Players win. Bray Wyatt versus Batista. Batista beat Bray Wyatt. Okay. So then you have Vaudevillains versus... Ooh, Blast from the Past there. Not past, really. But wait, kind of past. Recent past. Vaudevillains versus... Oh, gosh. Why did I forget the name again? Hart Foundation. This time, Bret Hart. Then you got RVD versus The Miz. And then Brock Lesnar versus Stone Cold. We've already seen that one, though. Alright. Let's take a quick look at... No. Let's take a quick look at some rankings. Brock Lesnar. Stone Cold is the number one contender for the WWE Championship. X-Pac, looks like, from the looks of things, it's supposed to be Brock Lesnar going to be going up against him. But it shows here the number one contender is Ryback. Then you got Vaudevillains, Lucha Dragons being the number one contenders, Paige as the women's champion, Nikki Bella as the number one contender, Baron Corbin as the NXT champion, Hideo Itami the number one contender, Tyler Breeze and Hideo Itami number one contender, The Ascension with the Red Faction as the number one contenders, but that's if The Ascension remain a tag team. We'll see what happens. Then Emma with Natalya as the number one contender. Okay. Over on SmackDown, you got Randy Orton and Seth Rollins coming up as the number one contender, even though the rivalry is Sheamus. Then you got The Rock with John Cena as the number one contender. We'll see what happens with that, because Kevin Owens is right on his heels. Golden Stardust has Enzo and Cass. Cameron has Tamina to deal with. So, that's how things are looking right now. But that is going to be it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed. And hope you can come back for the next one. Have a good one.